Partition your hair in a few sections, and that'll make it easier for me to evaluate it, okay? And you can let me know exactly what kind of hairstyle you're looking for, how you want me to shape it, etc. Okay. Do you want the sides to be lifted up and back? Right here, by your ears, all the way, trailing down to the back of your neck. Makes sense. Okay. And your sideburns, how do you like those? Yes, I can actually have those shaped for you. Wonderful. Let me just partition this part. Okay, and just raise it up in the back. Yes, do you want round or square on your neck? Okay, you got it. Absolutely, I know what you mean. I'm gonna give you some texture as well. I can feel that. Some parts are a little bit heavy and dense. Yeah, I can feel while I crunch your hair that there needs to be a little more featheriness to it, you know? Yes, you know what I mean. So I'll make sure that you have that volume and just nice and short. In the back, shape it just the way you like it. Okay, let's go ahead and start. Let's place a nice, comfortable cape on you. Right around your shoulder. Just make sure you're covered. That's perfect. There you go. I'll just clip this on the back. Perfect. Let me go ahead and partition your hair and just start to give this some shape. Okay. this is a family-owned business. It's actually been around since 1963. Oh, yeah. My grandfather, he started cutting hair when he was very young. He used to have a chair and a sign on his front porch. And everyone in the neighborhood would get their hair cut for like 75 cents or something like that. It was pretty cheap. And he got really good at it. He was very talented cutting hair. And it's so funny. He had very long hair, my grandfather. And he never really cut it. He cut so many people's hair. But he never really cut his own. I used to help him split ends and just to maintain his beautiful long hair. And I remember he used to fall asleep on the chair. I was like maybe 9, and I used to cut his split ends, and I'd even trim his beard. At that age, he taught me. I also learned from watching him work. And he would fall asleep. It was the sweetest thing. And I just love that. I guess I fell in love with tenderness of cutting someone's hair. It's a special thing. There's just something so soothing about it. And you need to have complete trust when someone's shaving you. It's a form of surrender. In a very comforting way. I became really cutting hair. I remember I cut all the hair off one of my dolls. Her hair just kept getting shorter and shorter. And I would beg my parents to buy me new dolls so I could cut their hair. And eventually, they said, I can't keep buying you dolls. So, my grandfather, he taught me how to cut hair professionally. And every day after school, I would help him at the barbershop. You could say this is kind of like my second home. You know, I'd make coffee and tea for people. I'd wash people's hair. fold towels and, you know, sweep up the hair, do all the little things to help him. And my sister, she was the beard master. It's sort of amazing when I think about how this barbershop started. It used to be an old restaurant a long time ago. My grandfather used to come in and talk to the owners, and he used to tell them, "One day, I'm gonna buy this place, and I'm gonna build a barbershop." And they would laugh at him, because he was so young. He was like maybe 16. Bragging about someday opening a shop. He worked really hard on a sugarcane farm, and he saved up money for years. He was very frugal, my grandfather. Still is. And finally, he was able to buy the place. Yes. And he built it from scratch. He was self-taught in plumbing, and the old restaurant owners. I think it was time for them to retire. And they really respected how hard he worked. I think they admired him. He promised them free haircuts for life. And he kept his word. He cut their hair all the way up until they were very old and they couldn't leave the house. And my grandfather would go over to their house and cut their hair at home. let me go ahead and texturize your hair a little bit. Look good. It gives you just a little bit of hair tug, but it's pleasant, right? Okay. You let me know if it's too much, then I will adjust for you. Okay. Oh, it's looking so beautiful on you. The shape is. I feel very lucky that I get to work with people I love. I love my boss, my abuelo. He has such a beautiful energy. He's just always grateful. No matter what happens, he's always in a good mood. I'm just gonna move your head down, just like this. That's perfect. Wonderful. This will just give me a better angle to work with your hair. I'm gonna focus on raising the portion on the back of the neck. My sister's going to prepare your hot foam shave. And she'll finish up your session. And that's going to take a minute to get hot. Make sure I have everything here. Bueno, let me adjust you so you can look up. That's better, yes. Wonderful. I'm going to start with steam for your face. It's very caliente. So you just have to trust me that I know exactly how to do it. Okay, bueno. Está bien caliente. I will be careful and just hold it a few inches away from your face, like that, and I will just send the steam to your face and get the skin nice and ready for the shave. If this is your first time, the hot foam sheath is the best. Oh yes. I have been doing this for a very long time. I can promise you, I am very careful. Okay? You can trust me. I use this straight razor to shave you. It's going to be the most relaxing the most beautiful shave ever. You have beautiful skin. Oh yes, I use the very best cream. supports a little bit on your neck. That's perfect. Bueno, you're going to have to stay very still. All you have to do is keep your face relaxed.